Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick in the Philippines. Hope you guys are doing all right. I wanted to pray for you guys, several people. Of course, I've got my list here. I probably got about 30 new names. I want to pray first, and I just want to pray for all those people, just for everybody, brothers and sisters. I'm playing a little music, if you can hear it on here. I'm playing a little Terry McCallman. I just want to pray for all you guys and for everybody. For Joshua's ministry, I ask you guys to come in agreement with me. So we pray for those who need prayer for Joshua's ministry. Again, I think we have 8 prayer warriors, too, for the website, for the virtual church, the online church, Church of the Firstborn. The link will be below this video. I asked you if you want to be a prayer warrior, if you are a serious prayer warrior. Please join us. We've got 8 solid people now. We have different ministries on there. We're looking to add more ministries. If you have a calling to serve the Lord, this is an opportunity for you to join our online ministry. As we're going to be serving those who the Lord leads us to. It's below here. So let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Lord. Hallelujah. We give you the praise, Lord God. Hallelujah. Father, you are worthy of all praise and glory. Hallelujah. Glory to the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord, God Most High. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory to the Lord God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you for the Holy Spirit, Lord God. We thank you, Lord, for the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. You said that we would be endowed with power from on high, that we might be witnesses of yours, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Today we receive power from on high. Hallelujah, Lord. Power, power, power. Wonder-working power. Hallelujah. We thank you for the Holy Ghost, Lord. Hallelujah, Father. We praise you, Father, for the Holy Spirit, Lord, that leads and guides us, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Your word said those who are led by the Spirit, these are the sons of God. Hallelujah. Romans 8:14. Thank you, Father, for the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Who? Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord, for in your word we can learn, Lord, hallelujah, that you, the Father, plans and the Son speaks, hallelujah, for he is the word, he speaks, and the Holy Spirit executes your will, Heavenly Father, hallelujah, hallelujah, Lord. So right now, Lord, we thank you that the Holy Spirit conforms us to the image of Christ, hallelujah, Lord, hallelujah, Lord, hallelujah, form in us, Lord God, create in me, O God. Hallelujah. Your will, Lord. Let your will be done, Lord. Lord, purify all the dross out of your people, Lord God, that we might be vessels of honor. Romans chapter 9. And not vessels of dishonor, Lord. Hallelujah. That we might bring glory to your holy name, Lord. Blessing and honor and glory and might and power be unto you, Lord. For you are worthy. You are worthy of all praise and glory. Hallelujah, Father. We praise you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Father, bless your people, Lord God. Bless thy people, Lord God, that they might be a blessing, Lord. Lord, even as the prayer of Jabez that was popular, Lord, in that prayer, Jabez prayed, Lord, bless me indeed. Hallelujah. Bless your people, Lord, that they might be a blessing, Lord God. Lord, expand our territory within your kingdom, Lord. Expand our tent in your kingdom, Lord God. Keep your hand upon us, Father. And protect us from evil. Father, we ask in Jesus' name. Blessed be your name, Lord God. We honor you. We praise you. We worship you. We exalt thee, Father. In Jesus' name, Lord God. You are worthy. For thou art worthy, Lord God, of all praise, all glory, and all honor. Forevermore, Lord God. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord God. And I've got a word for all of you. You are the salt of the earth. Hallelujah. This is the words of Jesus. And this is a Rhema word and right now word the Lord gave me for all those who are watching this. You are salt of the earth. But if salt has lost its savor, what good is it? It's only good to be thrown into the garbage pile, into the dung heap. Let not the savor of the living God inside you be gone. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Let the Lord rekindle that flame of his fire within you. What we call in modern words, revival. Let the Lord reignite you that you may be salt and light in this world. Hallelujah. As Jesus said, Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father as in heaven. And Jesus said that no one lights a candle and puts it under a basket. You know, a city on a hill cannot be hid. Can you imagine? I mean, most of you guys in modern day times, I mean, I was in the army, okay, and then I'm here in the Philippines. Most of you people, you know, you keep staying in your house and playing video games and going on the computer and all that. If you were to go out in the woods and then come upon a city that was on a hill, I mean, you can see it from a long way off. They call it, you know, the tree huggers call it light pollution. You know, you can see a city. You know, you can't see the stars because of the brightness of the city. Amen. So that's what Jesus said. You know, a city on a hill cannot be hidden because it's going to be seen in the daylight. And then at night, of course, there's going to be light there. Jesus was talking about light. It will be seen. So how can you light a candle and hide it? How can the Bible says the spirit of man is a candle of the Lord. So how is it that the spirit inside you, you're supposed to be filled with the Holy Spirit, but yet people don't know it. If you be filled with the Holy Spirit. Many of you have never been filled with the Holy Spirit. You've been sealed with the Holy Spirit, but you have not been filled with the Holy Spirit. You have not because you ask not. And when you ask amiss. You're not asking in faith, but to consume on your own lust. You're not seeking the Spirit of God that you might be salt and light to bring glory to His name, but you've been seeking the Spirit of God so that you might use God as your own personal servant. But my Bible says that we are the servants of God. He's not our servant, our errand boy, but we are His servants. The purpose of the Holy Spirit is to bring a dynamite power to this world that we might be witnesses, not only through preaching, not only through proclaiming the gospel, all you old denominational people, but through the signs and wonders of the Holy Spirit. If there's ever been a generation that needs to be signs to see signs and wonders, that's now. That's right now. We've got modern day medicines. We've got modern day technology. We've got air conditioning. We've got indoor plumbing and running water. We've got hot water. We've got all these things that people in all throughout history never had, all these things that the ever even kings and queens didn't have, the things that we have, the average person has today in the developed world. Electricity and all that, and modern day medicines and all that. If there's ever been a time for people to say, hey, we don't need God, it's now, because we have miracle drugs and miracle cures. You can live to be old through medicine and technology and all that today. Oh, you old Pharisees, all you old dead religious people who say, oh, well, you know, we've got the Bible now. We don't need any signs and wonders. What are you talking about? Now is the time. Look, if you come to a third world country like the Philippines and you go to a remote area, people have no money to go to the doctor. There's no good doctors anyway. If you get sick in the Philippines, you know, you're going to die from lack of professional medical care and modern day medicine and doctors that are competent, even in the Manila, they're not halfway competent. Haven't met one yet. So you have to rely on God because you don't have nothing else. But in America and in Europe and places like that, in the developed world, people, you know, have many excuses not to need God because of modern day technology. People need to see signs and wonders today more than ever, brothers and sisters. There's the rise of atheism and through the internet and all that, people can get all kinds of information they can never get before. Varieties of opinions and ideas that sounds good. People, as they say, as an example, Thomas Jefferson in his lifetime. Thomas Jefferson saw less people in his lifetime than a modern day American does walking through the average American city. If you were to walk through downtown during the business day in the average American city or through a mall, you would see more people in one day than Thomas Jefferson saw in his whole lifetime. That's how much this world has changed. That reminds me, you know, I got, even in my book, that's what I wrote about, how things have changed. We are living in the end times, and we need power. We need power from on high. We need revival. We need revival. We need revival. The word for all people is from the Lord right now. As I've already said, this is a word from the Lord to all people watching this video. If salt has lost its flavor or its savor, as the King James says, then what good is it? What good are you to the kingdom of God if you have no salt and light in you? Jesus said it's worth nothing but to be thrown in the garbage. Now, what part of thrown in the garbage sounds like once saved, always saved to you? God doesn't need you. You need God. That's what people don't understand. Jesus doesn't need us. We need Him. I'm trying to lower my voice because it's getting already pretty late here. I'm going to post this video and then I'm going to come back and make a video and pray for people. The Lord gave me this message. It wasn't my intention to give this message, but that's what the Lord gave me. And that's the word from the Lord for everybody. If you have lost your savor, your flavor, the power of God working within you, salt brings, just like when you put salt like on a ham. In my place, we have in North Carolina, we have something called country ham. You know, salt is used to cure meat, like you got your beef jerky and all that kind of stuff. Fish and whatever. In the Philippines, they dry fish and they use salt. Salt, it's got a strong flavor, but it purifies, it kills bacteria. Just like light. Light kills bacteria. If you have mold on something, you can go lay it in the sun, and that light would kill that bacteria. Did you know, brothers and sisters, I want to add this on here. The old house I used to live in, there's lots of rats in the Philippines because they have open sewers and the garbage and all that. There's no field sanitation here. There's no good sanitation. There's rats running. You can hear them. They squeal. You can hear them squealing all night long, running around. It's crazy. Third world fun. Anyway, I bought this trap at the old house where I used to live because we had rats coming in because they had holes in the ceiling. And I bought this trap, brothers and sisters, and it was like a cage thing that you catch a raccoon in or something. And I asked the people at the hardware store, what am I going to do with this rat once I got him in here? And they told me, all you have to do is set it in the bright sun. In about 2 hours, the rat will be dead from being in the bright sun for 2 hours. Rats cannot live in the sunlight. Did you know that? Think about this, brothers and sisters, as the Lord is inspiring me to say all this. Think about this. When do people get drunk and party and all that? In the night. And people who are drunk in the night. The Lord always gives me Bible verses, brothers and sisters. If you'll notice, the difference between true preaching and a lot of the junk that you'll see on YouTube and television, like Joel Osteen and that, they don't really give Bible verses. If someone's led by the Spirit, they'll be peppering their speech with lots of Bible verses. And praise God, God is the one that keeps giving me the Bible verses and giving me what to say. And it's confirmed by His Word, His Spirit, as He gives me the unction, and His Word. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, those who are drunk in the night. But we are not children of the night, but of the day, that the day of the Lord would not overtake us as a thief. Now the day of the Lord is referring to A, the rapture, B, the tribulation, C, the thousand-year reign of Christ. It's all the day of the Lord. So all of you out there who are cardinal-minded, and you've heard those cardinal-minded arguments about that the rapture is on the day of the Lord. A day with the Lord is just as a thousand years with us. So the thousand-year reign of Christ, really, plus the tribulation and the rapture, that's all the day of the Lord. It's not a literal man-made one 24-hour period, brothers and sisters. I had to throw that out there. God bless you guys. I love you guys. I'm going to come back and make a video praying for people. And this video is very important, and I showed that book because I only got one copy left here, and we're running out of signed copies. And I'm not happy with the fact about dealing with these books. The Lord gave me the book to write. The book is a call for revival. What I've been talking about, and that's why I picked up the book. Because what I'm talking about is really lined up with the message that's in my book. You know, and that's why when I come on here and say, well, you know, I wrote a book and the proceeds go to the orphanage and all that. But the real deal is the message of this book is what's wrong with the American church. They are dead. 99% of churches in the United States is not even Christianity anymore. It's time to come out from among them. You know, they won't receive prophets. I'm not the only prophet of God. There's lots of real prophets. And not all these old self-appointed clowns, the majority of them on YouTube calling themselves prophets, setting dates and all kinds of stuff. That's not what the job of a prophet is, setting dates about the rapture and all that stuff. The job of a prophet is to call God's people to repentance. If my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven, I will forgive their sins, and I will hear their land. 2 Chronicles 7:14, spoken by King Solomon at the dedication of the temple of King Solomon there in Jerusalem. prophets throughout the Old Testament and the prophets of the New Testament, the apostles too, they call people to repentance. It's not all about prophesying future events, even though that's part of it. But being a prophet is not about necessarily giving people words and all that kind of stuff, even though that's part of it. The main job of a prophet is to call people back to the foundation stones of the kingdom of God. And for us New Testament Christians, not for you law keepers, not for you Judaizers, and not for you greasy gracers, but for biblical New Testament Christianity, to come back to the foundation laid by the apostles on the top of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Word of God, the New Testament, as built, written by the apostles, built on the foundation stone, the Lord Jesus Christ. Everything else that's built is on the not on the foundation of the Lord Jesus Christ needs to be knocked down, plucked up, and knocked down and destroyed, just as Jeremiah answered his call to pluck up, to break down and destroy all things, man-made structures that's not built by the Spirit of the living God, even as the Bible says, again, Psalm 127, except the Lord build the house, those that labor, labor in vain. And that is what's happened to the Christianity. Those who built the house were not the Lord, but by their own spirit, by their own flesh, by their own will, for their own gain, have they built their own kingdoms. Thus their kingdoms come crashing down upon their head even in a moment, even in the twinkling of an eye. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ who are real Christians shall rise, and those of us who are the true body of Christ shall rise to meet them in the air and meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we forever be with the Lord. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16, 17, and 18. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. For the Lord is about to take his church, and sudden destruction is coming upon all of these people that think they're the church, all of this Christendom, all these false teachers, false prophets all of those people, whether they claim to be no matter what denomination they claim, whether they claim to be Baptist, Assemblies of God, Catholic, whatever they are, filled with the spirit of the devil, full of the spirit of Jezebel. Some, as we know, the most blatant one, of course, as we know about Catholicism, worshiping the Virgin Mary. I just went out to a remote area. We're starting some new feedings, and I went there, and reasons of some people that I know, I went there. There was a high school graduation. And there was the bishop of the archdiocese of this island was there speaking, and I heard his teaching. And the motto of the school is to Jesus through Mary. And he said they swore to the last drop of blood to dedicate themselves to the Virgin Mary and to the Holy Catholic Church. Out of the mouth of the bishop, repeated and chanted back by the people to the last drop of blood, to defend to the last drop of blood, the Holy Catholic Church and the Virgin Mary, the Blessed Virgin Mary. Totally different religion. That Catholic bishop said, we are all good, because the Catholic bishop gave the opposite of the gospel. He said, God is good, we're created in his image, so all people are good because we're created in the image of God. And if anybody does bad, they've chosen to do bad and they've chosen not to do good. That's the gospel message that he gave. That's the opposite of the gospel. My gospel says, my Bible says that all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. There is none righteous, no, not a one. It's also known as the Roman road, right? Romans 3:23, Romans 6:23, Romans 10:9-10. If you can confess with your mouth, believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord and God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. You know, it's because with the heart you believe unto salvation. So that's just the one that people talk about. All these denominations you see, your Joel Osteen's and all that, and Robert Schuller's on TV, Crystal Cathedral, no more. No more. It's gone. It's no more of that. The Robert Schuller show is gone. Praise God for one less power of positive thinking, false doctrine churches is gone. God bless you guys. God bless you guys. Do not compromise. You must be salt and light. Do not compromise the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. You want to go in the rapture? You want to go to heaven? You want to be a Christian? Do not sell your soul. For what would a man give in exchange for his soul, the Lord Jesus Christ said? Or what good does it do for a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul? Or what would a man give in exchange for his soul? That's another Bible verse. You know, I don't usually say, when I'm doing my videos, I don't usually say, oh, always it's a Bible verse. Half of what I said is straight up Bible verses. Now, when you listen to lots of teaching, the people they're not using Bible verses. Hint, 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 hint. It's not really truth. It's not really from the Lord if there's not filled with the Word of God. And the problem with most of the people that's watching this video, you do not know the Bible. You don't read the Word. You're running to and fro on YouTube trying to find out the date of the rapture. Children of the light will not be taken by surprise. Those who read their Bible, those who are filled with His Spirit, led by His Spirit, those who are truly born-again Christians, they will not be surprised. That day will not overtake them as a thief. Today is the day of salvation. Today is the day for you to repent of being a lack of savor in your salt. Today is the day of you repent for lighting a candle and sticking under a bush. You know, your light has not so shined before men. They haven't seen your good works, and you have not glorified your Father in heaven. The summer is gone. The day is far spent. You know, darkness is here and we are not saved. Another Bible verse I paraphrased. That's what's upon this world right now, brothers and sisters. I speak to you right now by the Spirit of the living God. Deep darkness is moving upon this earth even as we speak. The hand of God is against the sin of this world. And the Lord, the whole tribulation period is about one thing. As it says in Daniel, it lists, Gabriel told Daniel the things that God's coming to do, to put an end to sin. You know, to bring in the everlasting covenant. God is going to restore this earth back to what it was before the fall. It's a process. We've already been spiritually saved at the resurrection of Christ when we're born again. And then the earth, the creation, the whole creation groaneth in travail. For the restoration of all things, that's from the Bible too, from Romans. The creation is in travail, in labor. The seven-year tribulation is the labor of the creation to bring forth the millennial reign of Christ, to put it into sin. That's what's coming. The travail is upon a woman now. And people are not going to escape, the Bible says. They shall not escape. Just like the flood, the days of Noah, the flood came, boom. They said peace and safety, then boom, sudden destruction. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. When they say peace and safety, then sudden destruction comes upon them like travail upon a woman. That's what's coming. That's what's even now, even at the door. Even at the door. Even at the door. I don't know how. Should I tap dance and say it? You need to repent. You need to get right with God. Because there is no more time. I mean, I don't know what else to do, brothers and sisters. I don't know what else to say. You know, people are without an excuse. Americans are without an excuse. Western people are without an excuse. Anyone that's watching the news is without excuse. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent, 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 for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Don't let anybody tell you don't need to repent. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Turn from your wicked ways and seek His face. Call upon Him, and He will answer you and show you great and mighty things that you know not. He will deliver you. He will show you His salvation. Psalm 91. I already quoted Jeremiah 33. Now Psalm 91. I'm going to try to name the Bible verses as I quote them. So the Lord is saying to me, why does the Lord show you His salvation? Because you've set your love upon Him. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High God shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my strength, my strong tower. In Him shall I trust. Put your trust in the Lord Jesus Christ today. Set your love upon Him, as it says also in Psalm 91. Set your love, set your affections on things above, not on things below. Get your eyes off of your worldly possessions. So what? Many of you have gained the whole world through your businesses and all that you've done and all the things that you've had in this world, material possessions. For women, maybe it's jewelry, pocketbooks, all them things. Men, it's to, you know, build a business or have more money or a nicer house, all the things you've done. Get your eyes off of the material things in your life. Do not be deceived by the riches of this world, for even this very night your life could be required of you. Set your affections on things above. Store up your treasures in heaven, where you'll have it for eternity. Stop living in the flesh. Live by the Spirit of the living God. People that are full of the devil and unrepentant will say, oh, you're trying to scare us. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power and of love and a sound mind. 2 Timothy 1:7. If you're in Christ, you be a new creature. Behold, old things are passed away. All things become new. New creature in Christ. If you're born again, you become a new creature in Christ. Those former things have passed away. They're dead with Christ, nailed to the cross, were crucified and buried with Christ in baptism, and were resurrected with Him through baptism. Brothers and sisters, today is the day of salvation. Repent. Get right with God. I can't say it enough. Time is up. Time is over. Game over, man. Game over. For you who are Christians, be at peace. For the Lord is with thee. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Praise be to God, creator of heaven and earth, who has made us a little lower than the angels, that He might manifest Himself through us by His Spirit, by His glory, by His grace, by His mercy. That the Lord has indwelt us with power from on high, that we might be a witness. And I command you this day in the name of Jesus Christ to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit and be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, by reading the Word of God and by being filled today with this Holy Spirit. Now stop resisting, you stiff-necked and hard-hearted people who doth always resist the Holy Ghost. Though you may stone God's people, God will stone you at the day of judgment, which is nigh approaching, and even at the door as I speak. It's even at the door. For you bear false witness against God's people. You bear false witness against His true church. And thus by the same measure you judge, it'll be measured back to you. O ye false religion, false Christians, false churches, the same measure that you use, it'll be measured back to you. Sevenfold, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, will the Lord give unto you for your deeds, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.